to shreds. And Zark, I feel like, just suffocated Classic out eventually, as you said. He had four bases, eventually was getting a fifth, and Classic just didn't have enough production on those three.
He also made a ton of observers. He spent a lot of robo-time doing that. A few more mortals might have behooved him. And also, as our observer was pointing out towards the end of that game, he had a huge surplus of gas because of those huge Zealot Warpins, but he was a bit late on getting those Archons in there. So, you know, his army was a bit lopsided that way.
Yeah. Well, guys, the second map here is going to be Lurelek Crest, and Dark looking really happy in that booth, actually, right now. Seems like he may be chatting a bit with Classic about that last game.
Yeah, looks like it. I think even Classic saying he was lucky just looking at his computer there for a second.
Yeah. Well, guys, we're going to go straight into game number two right now between Dark and Classic. So here we are on Lurelek Crest in the bottom right. It is Zerg player Dark in the red.
And his opponent to the top left in blue is Classic, his teammate in Pro League, his partner in crime. But today only one will advance to the semis of the winner's bracket. The other will fall down to losers.
Yeah.
Classic looking to go for a Nexus first here.
And this is really interesting. Dark once again going for the pool first with the gas. Going to look to get that early link speed and put on the pressure. And Classic on the other hand. I mean, this is a very big map and they are at cross spawn. So Classic is going to have a lot of time to get up his Sim City and possibly a couple of units to defend this.
Yeah. We'll see this natural now taken here for Dark. The transition to heavy lings and droning up after a commit to early lings like this won't be as easy, just simply because it's not a gold base. But it's not as early as a pool as last game, it doesn't look like, so it's going to be a quick queen instead, almost like a safety build. And, you know, initially it's very safe, and then after he gets speed out, which he can start like right now if he wants to, he can use that to bully, control the map, delay the third base, which is so important in Legacy. Holding off on it for now, which could mean that he wants to use that gas for something else. It could be tricky. It could be like a roach push or something, which is quite strong on this map.
Well, it does eventually go for that speed, was just delaying it for a bit. Maybe wanted a bit more information on where Classic may have been. He did get the overlords to both sides, so he knows that they are cross spawns now. And yeah, on this map for that third base, we do have rocks that do go into the third base, so maybe Dark wants to start getting some damage done there so he can eventually start to put on some pressure on that third base, as you were saying.
Yep. This core is going to finish with the second gateway in just a moment, so we can start to see those adepts come out, and we'll see how much Classic wants to pressure with them. A lot of his PVTs were played and won with that single unit before it was nerfed slightly.
Yeah.
It's, you know, the nerf doesn't really affect this matchup all too much. It does affect it, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it's pretty significant, but it's not like Terran where it was specifically designed to stop the Adept from killing Marines and SCVs as quickly as it was there. So.
Well, Classic has got two gateways up here and a third one on the way, going to consistently make a bunch of Adepts. And just over here checking actually for a possible Overlord that may want to come in, or maybe just a Nidus, if that eventually does come down here.
That was really cool, just that he was using the Shade Patrol. I don't know if he wanted to cancel or not. He didn't end up canceling it, but that was pretty interesting nonetheless. But at any rate, you know, this game has kind of transitioned into a normal one. Dark does have that link speed, which he can't do anything with aggressively yet, but he's just droning up as a result. And good coverage here against the Overlords. He's really expecting either, like you said, the Nidus player just wants to make sure he can keep the Overlords out. He doesn't have any Stalkers, so he's not going to be successful in that, but I think he wants to, as best as possible, hide the adept numbers. He's about to have three more. Roachworn coming up here for Dark now.
Yeah, Dark has just kind of sat back and macroed up here, only making four more lings now, and a lair finally on the way. Just wanted to secure that three base economy and get his economy up and running first. Now making a bunch of lings, as you said, maybe to put a bit of pressure onto this third base, probably just to control the map and make sure he's okay if any Protoss attack does come across the map.
Yeah, well, with nine adepts, he's definitely going to start poking and prodding with them a little bit. He hid them pretty well, but now they're going to be seen by this watchtower.
Oh boy.
And here comes the pain.
And Dark just made nine drones, so he's going to desperately have to get some units up here. He's got five roaches on the way, but this is a lot of adepts coming in. Can easily fight only these lings.
Yep, and he's going to want to get into an angle. That's exactly right, right there in the corner. And Dark's lings cannot get much surface area. These queens are really a godsend right now, actually helping him quite a bit versus this. But they're off creep, they're slow, and by the time he gets over here, he could just simply teleport into the main.
Oh, look at this. Just a couple of roaches now to get in here and try to defend. One more adept now going into the third base. And this is kind of an early sendback for those drones, possibly losing six so far, and the adepts are not dead just yet.
Yeah, there's one actually doing damage there at the third base as well. Drones finally being pulled here. It looks like Dark was almost just simply prioritizing mining over, you know, the life of his drones. Look, it's again another shade, and there's nothing here, not even a queen. And this is way too much damage. He's now down 10 workers. And this is just a big mess.
These adepts aren't really done yet. They have shaded once again. Finally, with enough lings out here, are going to get surrounded and killed.
He has to counterattack right now, Valdez. He has to go and hit that third base right now. It's his only chance.
Yeah. Be interested to see exactly what Classic has back here. He's got kind of a ragtag bunch of units over here with about four or five sentries. That's really going to be the key. He has to delay here for a long time.
Yeah, these pylons are ready, which is going to make this hold a lot easier. Some Ravagers would definitely help this attack, but I don't think he's going to go for it. He's going Spire Tech instead back at home. Roach Speed is about to finish, and he is going to unlock this third, this pathway to the third base. Well, this is actually going to be very difficult for Dark to pull off, just simply because Classic knows this is coming. He's got even an Observer out here now. He can still force shield this area. Although he doesn't have vision of that, he must know what's going on. Okay, now he definitely knows.
Now he knows, yeah.
He needs to get those units over there.
Here come the units. He doesn't have the pylons ready right now, so he needs to delay over here with those force fields. Thankfully, he does get there just in time, but now a rotation from Dark looking to pressure the front. I think it should be okay. It's not too far away for Classic to defend, and he does have that Mothership Corn position.
His multitasking being tested here a little bit. You know, he could split his army in half, but I think maybe some nerves affecting him here. Just want to point out that Classic is up four workers right now. There is a fourth base coming up for Dark right now, but still, never a good place to be as a Zerg when you're down in Harvesters. The double Stargate is definitely going to be for double Phoenixes, which will be the answer for these Mutalists.
Yeah, and Dark has seen both of those Stargates coming up there with his Overseer, so he does know that they are on the way and that Phoenixes will be made. He still decides to make six Mutalists. Going to be interesting to see where he can try to get damage with that, possibly try to sneak them around.
This is brave here, but this will delay the Mutalist attack for him to get a few Phoenixes out. Just going to drop these Zealots and sacrifice them and target down drones. Mutalists have to stay home. The Warp Prism actually goes home scot-free, even hold positions the Zealots here. And, you know, kills four workers. Warp Prism goes home free. He's got a third Stargate on the way now. And his second Robo. So this is going to be the way of every PvZ. You know, you go double Stargate into double Robo. We're going to see a Templar Archive come up soon. And I think he's really counting on Dark committing more to those Mutalists. He didn't cancel his other Stargate, right? He may have, actually. Or maybe this one is just simply not finished yet, and I thought they were made at the exact same time. I think that's actually what happened.
Yeah, that's what happened.
Okay, so he only has two Stargates. My apologies. We switched seats today. I'm usually the guy who's jumping around the computer. Today it's you.
Yeah, I'm like trying to do it now. I'm not used to it, but we're going to make it work.
We're going to make it work. It's going to be fine.
Yeah.
Everybody relax. And one guy's like, I don't know. How could they not know? He's like, oh, I was paying attention. I don't have a computer either. Well, it's going to be hard for Classic to take a fourth base, actually, as it still is in this game. He's not, you know, he's not being aggressive with his army, but he's got enough units to push the Lings away. But once the Lurkers come out again, if the Lurkers siege up that fourth, even if he was ahead before, he's not going to be able to take it. He's going to get starved out. 12 Lurkers.
Yeah, I was about to say, look at how many are coming up at this point in time. I don't believe there is Storm on the map just yet. Just a lot of sentries. And Classic, in fact, is looking to move out and possibly pressure before the Lurkers are done. But they are already completed. And Dark has a nice little counterattack force, something he's very well known for, you know, to keep the Protoss army back and buy him a lot of time so that he can be very well prepared for this attack.
Now notice the position of these mutas, as well as the spore crawlers. He's going to be looking for observers really hard right now, because if he can kill the observers, these lurkers cannot be killed. And that's the real key here.
Yeah, and then the Protoss just cannot fight.
Yeah.
You know, he needs to take out those, or he needs to have vision of the Lurkers. We finally do have the Templar Archives completed. Immediately Storm has started. Obviously, something Classic is looking to complete as soon as possible.
Yeah, and anyone who's played PBZ from, you know, the Brood War era could tell you that Storm is one of those great things versus Lurkers, because if everything goes to hell and your observer ends up dying, you can at least just kind of storm in that general direction and pick a lot of them off anyways.
There's a couple of cute force fields there to take off a chunk of Dark's army.
Yeah, very nice interception here, but it buys Dark, again, further time to get maxed out. 9 more Hydras on the way, and I have a feeling many of them will be turned into Lurkers. Little cute Zealot drop coming in here at the back of this third base. And actually, there's nothing here right now. Let's see if Dark decides to turn around and send some Lings home.
Just drop 2 Zealots into that fourth base. Looking to drop a bit more into that natural. But that's a really, really scary army for Dark that's in the middle of the map right now. Still 12 Lurkers remain. I think he needs a little bit more support, maybe more Roaches in the mix.
Well, he's good. He's got a few Hydras here. It's, again, all about the Storms. Where do they hit? It's not finished yet. It's finishing in 5 seconds now. He's getting also an Oracle, which is going to make it easier to detect them. But he has, you know, 5 Sentries, which aren't going to be very useful at all. He'd probably want to exchange those for better units. And as you guys can see here, he's just trying to find an angle. Phoenixes do kind of help push this away. So he's going to trade those Mutas.
Yeah, Mutas not really the best spot. He's really just zoning out Classic's army here with the Lurkers in the middle of the map and attempting to come in at that side entrance. And now it looks like, in fact, Classic does want to push forward, lay down some of those Storms, but taking a lot of damage to his Immortals now.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, where he actually control-click barriered those Immortals. I think he wanted to barrier one at a time, but he accidentally did all of them. So now all barriers are on cooldown for the Immortals, and that means that they're not going to be able to fight up on the front lines very easily, especially with their clunky, you know, clumped-up nature. Little crab units coming across the map. It starts to look like StarCraft 1, like Dragoons walking into Lurkers. Look at this. I love the way he just wedges in between Classic's, you know, his third and his fourth base here, and sends Hydras to poke these pylons, and then if the Protoss army comes from the left, he can just run them back, and there's Lurker support.
Yeah, well, both players now have maxed out, and a lot of Storms available here. A huge amount of Immortals also in the mix for Classic, adding a bunch of Archons. He's preparing the perfect army composition to fight this army of Darks, kind of what he did not have in the last game.
Yeah, because this game he got a fourth base. This time he got the fourth, so he has all that extra money. Last game he couldn't get that. Oh, I like this, sending these Lurkers over here. Gonna force detection at both sides now as well. And look at this, he brings an Overseer with these Hydras. Look at the Snipe Observers. There's no cannons here right now. But
yeah, this is so smart. This is what you need in Legacy of the Void. You need to have this kind of multitasking to just slowly pull your opponent apart. But look at this. Classic is coming in for the fight. He knows this army is split apart, but Classic taking a huge amount of damage. The Storms not hitting the right targets, and just a huge amount of health lost on all of that army of Classic.
Oh, man. This is what, you know, I could, you know, when we talked to Classic earlier, who was basically joking, saying Zerg was strong. I feel like he's really struggling to deal with this teammate's aggression here. He's not splitting his units very well, and he's losing ground every second.
Man.
Now he's going to lose his fourth. And don't forget, Dark has 3k, 2.5k in the bank. He's going to start a Hive in a second. He just got his Infestation Pit. He can do whatever he wants from here. He can go Vipers. He can go Ultras.
Yeah.
He has infinity money.
And that was the nail in the coffin. He got those Lurkers at the bottom of that natural ramp, took out the fourth base, and there's absolutely nothing Classic has here to fight off this army.
I'm going to say something that's like not even very technical or even analytical, but I feel like Classic has no confidence to fight this army too. Remember that a few fights he almost committed but didn't? He accidentally full barriered his Immortals. That kind of move just leads me to believe he's himself not 100% sure how to deal with this composition yet in Legacy of the Void. That's the kind of move where you look at and you see him attack and he's like not sure himself as a pro gamer, as a professional, if this is going to work or not, and he decides halfway through to back off, and this is going to be a slow and painful death from now on here, Valdez.
I love the switch in Tamita's, by the way. He knows there's not so many storms left, and he knows that a bunch of Immortals are going to be pumped out here to just deal with this army in general. So switching into those Mitas is going to be so annoying. I think the Phoenixes are also really cut down in number, so he could use those to just pull the army apart once again.
Yep, he's only got two Phoenixes left. The majority of them died in that last engage. And just more and more units getting replaced with Mutas here. And he hasn't even shown them yet. He's about to find out. 15 Mutas on the map currently with 8 more on the way. And he reveals them. That's the best he can do so far.
Yeah, 13 more on the way and still such a huge number out here. We do see more Archons being made in hopes of dealing with this, but only one cannon and not much anti-air is going to put Classic in a rough position here.
Yeah, well, here you go. I mean, there's a ton of Immortals here, so even the Hydras are having difficulty, but he pulls back to a few Lurkers. Barriers go up on the Immortals, but the Mutas are just going to focus fire them down. And even though the ground army is wiped away, who cares? The ground army of the Pros is about to follow suit. Targets the Archons. GG! Dark will take the series versus his teammate 2-0, and we'll move on to the round of 4.
Yeah, Dark playing just a fantastic couple of games there. As you mentioned before, Classic didn't really seem like he was confident against the play of Dark. Dark just outplayed him at every turn in both those games.
Yeah, and just in the second game, you know, he had a fourth base up. He was building, as you said, I think, like, you know, you basically summed it up. Like, he was building the perfect Protoss army. He was building the answer, but he wasn't confident to engage. He had that one. This is actually a best of 5, not a best of 3. I just was told. Every information I had before that was the opposite. So I'm like, okay, this is not over. That means we have like, you know, a longer period to actually
possibly 3 more games if Classic does pull this back. But
well, thank God it's a best of 5.
Yeah, I was going to say, is that really it? You know, just one best of 3?
I was thinking about that earlier, like when we were on the way to the studio. I'm like, I can't believe the round of 8 is best of 3s. Yeah. All right,
so,
well.
We couldn't believe it, and it's not true. So anyway, guys, we're going to go to a 5-minute break. We'll be right back with game number 3.